بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I will start our lesson inshallah and our study with a question. This question I'm asking all brothers and sisters. I'll give you 5 seconds to think about the answer. What's your aim in this life? What's your aim in this life? 5 seconds. What's your aim in this life? Okay, Qasim.
To do
good deeds and go to heaven, inshallah, to Jannah. Ameen. How?
Pray 5 times a day.
Good things. MashaAllah. Good, ya Sheikh Qasim. MashaAllah. Sheikh Omar?
The aim is to constantly try and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that the day of judgment, given the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you're able to get to Jannah.
MashaAllah. So your aim in this dunya is the Jannah?
No.
So this dunya will lead you to Jannah?
You can get to Jannah, but you can also get to
Jahannam
due to the
Jannah. May Allah protect all of us from Jahannam.
It's like a process. You have to first of all seek the knowledge. And then you have to put that knowledge in order to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked you to do. And then inshallah, on your deathbed, you're able to die as a Muslim.
Ameen,
ya Rabb. When you are questioning your grave, you're able to answer the questions. And then when you're standing in front of Allah, not only do your deeds outweigh your bad deeds, your good deeds outweigh your bad deeds, but you're also given the mercy of Allah.
Naam.
So you can get to
Jannah. Inshallah.
What Allah has instructed you.
So you want to follow the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is to follow the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. MashaAllah. Sheikh Umair.
Sunnah, what you said.
MashaAllah. This is the simplest and best answer, yeah? MashaAllah. Good. Say Sheikh Shafiq.
Yeah, I mean, similar, but I mean, obviously, pleasing Allah.
Naam.
That would be your name. Life.
نعم. ما شاء الله. ما شاء الله. Good. Sheikh عبد الرحمن.
Thing that I'm trying to say, this I cannot work because the world in this dunya also. تعمير.
عمار الأرض. Building. نعم.
Because Allah سبحانه وتعالى asked our Lord to do it.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Even if you see the sun comes out from the west.
نعم. Planet, yeah, Versa. Planet, yeah, tree.
Yeah, you planted, yeah. Nam. It's also part of the requirement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, as a Muslim, we have to balance between the dunya and the akhirah.
So we have to make a balance between dunya and akhirah. MashaAllah. Good.
Even our niyyah, the adab, the normal things, our actions, we did sometimes, we did all the actions we did that. The normal, we don't have reward of that. If we put an intention in order to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we get the reward of that. For example, if I sleep, I go in my intention, I sleep in order to be strong in
the to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help me and get the reward.
Naam. InshaAllah. Ya Rabb. Dr. Waleed.
Almost all the point has been discussed.
Naam.
The aim is to please Allah and to go to the Jannah.
Naam. This is our aim in dunya.
Or Jahannam. as my brother said, it's a hadith in which Rasul says,
سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب says. سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب نعم.
سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب says. اعمل لدنياك كأنك تعيش الأبد وعمل لآخرتك
كأنك تموت غدا. That's right. نعم.
It's like you have to work for your life.
نعم.
Like if you will you will live forever. And you should work your akhirah like you will.
As you are going to die tomorrow.
Yeah.
Naam. Jazakallah khair. Good. Brother, what's your name, Sheikh?
Zakaria.
Zakaria. MashaAllah. Ahlan wa sahlan.
Same
thing. So, like Umair. Naam. Sheikh Hassan?
Same. Plus.
Plus. V80.
Seeing the face of Allah.
Oh, MashaAllah. This is will lead to. What you are doing in dunya, that will lead to that aim yawm al-qiyamah. Sheikh Abdul Bari. Abdul?
Abdul Wahid.
Abdul Wahid.
all of the above.
Naam.
Plus? Plus Allah, Brother Hassan said, definitely.
Naam. To see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Rab, all of us, ameen, ya Rab. Sheikh Yasir. MashaAllah. So as far as I see, MashaAllah, all of you here, that your target or your aim to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are thinking about Yawm Al-Qiyamah, to get the best reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the best reward or ajr or gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the maximum thing which we can dream. But we can see that there are some other people, from Muslims even, that they are running behind dunya. They are running behind dunya. Dr. Waleed mentioned the hadith or the qawl of Sayyidina Ali bin Abi Talib رضي الله عنه, اعمل لدنياك كأنك تعيش أبدا واعمل لآخرتك كأنك تموت غدا. Do for your dunya as you are staying alive all your life, and do for your akhirah as far as you are going to die tomorrow. If you are going if you feel that you are going to stay all your life alive, what you will do? You will do many things in your mind. You want cars, houses, whatever, because this is your dunya. At the same time, if you want to do for your akhirah, if you know that I'm sure tomorrow you are going to die. If somebody tells you tomorrow you are going to die, no way, khalas, this is the conclusion, what you will do. SubhanAllah, I was watching a program in a TV, and the question was, imagine that this is your last day. What you will do in this last day? And unfortunately, it's not Islamic program. It's Arab program, but it's not Islamic program. They were saying that I want to visit Japan. I want to see China. I want to dive. I want to jump from airplane. I want to achieve what I didn't achieve before. So all of these things for dunya, not akhirah. Well, if you feel that you are going to die tomorrow, surely I'm sure that all of us will make ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise us up yawm al-qiyamah at the situation how we passed away. يُبْعَثُ الْمَرْءُ كَيْفَ مَاتْ. If you pass away or if you die while you are praying, يوم القيامة will be raised up praying. If you are doing good deeds, it will be the same. If you are doing bad deeds, it will be the same. So you have to think about yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you this chance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us. Some people running, as I said, they forgot or they forget the akhirah, and they think that they are staying forever alive. And I mentioned that before. If I ask us, ourselves now, if I ask ourselves, who think that he is going to die tomorrow? Nobody. Always we make plans for after 5 years, after 10 years, after whatever, and it's not haram. It's good to make plans. I'm not saying it's haram. But at the same time, you have to think, this is my plan. And maybe there will be something stopping this plan. which is death. And what will happen after that? I know somebody, and I met somebody in Jordan, for example. He was a very old man, and even he was thinking about his future. What will happen? He's a very old man, and he's ill man. What you will do? And he's walking, and he's going, خلاص, you feel that he's going to die. And he was thinking how I will drive my car, how I will do in my land, how I'll farm the land, or whatever. Next day he passed away. Subhanallah. Was he thinking that he is going to die tomorrow? No. He was thinking that, although he's about 80, something like that, he was thinking that I'm going to stay forever. He was planning for what he was going to do. As I said, many people, they are thinking about dunya. They don't think about akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us cushion. Or when you are asleep and you want to wake up, what you will do? You put your alarm, yeah? To wake up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now giving us this alarm, which is Surah At-Takathur. Surah At-Takathur. Now, as I said, many people thinking about dunya and they don't think about akhirah at all. Thinking about increasing their wealth, their money, whatever they can to increase it for their benefit, and they don't think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ringing the bell, as we say in Arabic, man yaqra' al-jaras, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you a caution. What is this? Surah At-Takathur, and this is our subject, insha'Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with Al-Hakum At-Takathur. Al-Hakum At-Takathur. What's the meaning of At-Takathur? At-Takathur. From Kathir. Kathir, when you say Kathir, seeking more to increase. Al-Hakum At-Takathur. So, you want to increase your wealth. You want to increase your trade, you want to increase your shops, you want to increase your sons, you want to increase your children, as you said, that's right, Jazakallah khair. You want to increase everything for your benefit. And this is well known in Arab countries. For example, many people, they want many children because they think that if I have many children, that will be considered as a power for me in the future. And we mentioned that in the story of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his grandfather and his father, that his grandfather has only one son. And you know the story of Ibn al-Dhabihain, you remember? Sheikh Hassan, you mentioned, I asked you answered that question. Ibn al-Dhabihain, we said Sayyidina Ismail was Sayyidina, the father of Sayyidina Abdullah al-Dhabihain. So the people, the nature of Arab, they want to increase their children. They want to increase their wealth. As we see, some people, they want to open shops. If I have a shop, if I have a shop here, I want to open a branch in another city. Another branch in another city, another branch in another city. It's not haram. I can't say it's haram. But at the same time, you shouldn't be busy about these things. It shouldn't be your concern, your life running, sorry to say, like a dog behind this dunya. Because you will not be enough. For that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he recited Surah at Al-Hakum At-Takathur, he said, "Yaqulu bani Adam," by the meaning, "Yaqulu bani Adam, mali mali." The bani Adam, the son of Adam, will say, "My money, my money." But what's your money? What, your money is what you've eaten. When you eat, what will happen? You'll take it out, you'll go to toilet. And your money, what you did wear. And this clothes, what will happen to it? Tear, khalas, will finish. And your money, which is remain, or and what you make sadaqah, that will stay forever in the balance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what remain is not your money. What remain is not your money, it will go to your Waratha, heritage. Yeah, it will go to your waratha. So it's not your money. So if you have millions in the bank and you don't spend them, after you die, it will not be your money. We mentioned the hadith that when son ibn Adam pass away or die, what will happen? يتبعه أهله وماله وعمله. When the son of Adam going to grave, what will follow him? His family, his son, his children, his money, his wealth, and his deeds. Now, when you go to grave, what will be with you? Your deeds and your wealth will go. It will not stay with you. Your family will go. How many days they will cry? 1 day, 2 days, 1 year, but they will forget you. And they will use your money. They will use your money. Nobody will remember you after that. Maybe if you have a righteous son, will remember you in some deeds. But what you collected will go to them. So it will not be your money. So you have to be careful about that. Instead of running about money and increasing your wealth, as I said, it's not haram, but at the same time, you have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these things. Don't be busy in these things. And as I mentioned before, many people, they don't reach the mosque at all. Even the time of Salat al-Jum'ah, they didn't go to Salat al-Jum'ah. They want to increase their business. Especially in this country, unfortunately, I saw some Muslim shops, they don't close Yawm al-Jum'ah. They stay open because it's lunchtime, and they want to sell in lunchtime, which is haram. And you know, according to hadith, that every contract at the time of Jum'ah is invalid. Every contract at the time of Jum'ah is invalid.
Sheikh,
no.
Sometimes there is Salat and Jum'ah is it in the same time? Like there is two Jum'ah?
Yeah, it's different.
One hour before the other.
Yeah, that's different. You know, before 2 days, brother phoned me and he asked this question, that imagine that Salat al-Jum'ah in Masjid Umar, 12:30. In Masjid Abu Bakr, 1 o'clock. In Masjid al-Ummah, 1 o'clock. Say, if we are two in one shop, one goes to Masjid Umar, and when he comes back, another one goes to Masjid Abu Bakr. So that's okay, fine. But my example is about some people who don't go to the mosque. So we can't say that their salah is not accepted or their business, because there is a jama'ah and the brother will join the jama'ah. That's fine. But I'm saying another thing, that they stay open and they don't go at all to the mosque. For what? And you may pay this money for your health. You may become ill. You may need to buy medicine. And what you collected, it will go just like that. So you have to be careful, think about it. And we know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, دَاوُوا مَرْضَاكُمْ بِالصَّدَقَةِ. Treat, give medicine for your ill people by sadaqa. If you have a person who is ill, pay sadaqa. That will help to treat him. Or unless if there is, subhanAllah, a time for death, khalas, yani it's the time of death. Or another hadith, inna sadaqata, the charity, the sadaqa, tutfi'u ghadab al-Rabb, finishes the ghadab of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to be careful about these things. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again says about Ibn Adam, the son of Adam, that if you have a mountain of gold, imagine that you have a mountain of gold. It's a big wealth, yeah? You still want another mountain. If you have whatever, you still need more and more and more. وَمَا مَلَأَ عَيْنُ ابْنُ آدَمْ إِلَّا التُّرَابِ. Nothing will fill your eye, just what? The soul. When you go to grave, you know, the soul will come to your eye and that's it. That will finish your dreams. So this is the nature of Bani Adam. But what's the difference of Bani Adam, the normal Bani Adam, and the righteous Bani Adam? As brother Abdul Rahman mentioned, I have to make niyyah and everything. If I pay money for something, I have to pay niyyah to be a sadaqah. If I do, as he said, if I sleep, I may mean that I'm sleeping to give myself strength so I can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't be busy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning you now. Be careful. Don't be busy running behind the dunya. Because some people that has done that, you've done that. حتى زرتم المقابر ألهاكم التكاثر. You became running behind dunya till you visited the graves or graveyards. Now there are different meanings of this ayah. حتى زرتم المقابر. Again, we related to the Arab in that era. They were very proud about their families. Even we say, oh, my tribe is Hamad, and we have 1,000 members of Hamad. Another person will say, my family is a Saudi, and we have more than you. So no, you don't have more than me. Let us go to graveyard and count the people who passed away, collect them together. So even they went to graveyards, to cemetery, to calculate how many person from Hamad or Al Saudi, to see how many members, how many person from my family. Even they were proud of the deaf people. So this is one meaning. Another meaning that حتى زرتم المقابر, you were busy in this dunya till you die, and you visited the graves. If I die, will I visit the grave? What do you think? I'm there. It's my home, yeah? No. I will visit. It's not my home. Because your home will be either Jannah or in Nar. So are you visiting this grave for a while? And after that, you will go to your home. Inshallah, all of us, inshallah, ya Rab, ameen. May Allah make us from the people of Al-Jannah, Al-Firdaws Al-A'la, and give us the opportunity to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are busy running till you go to die, and at that time, what will happen? As I said, nothing will stay with you of your wealth. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. No, or nay, you will know. You will know. ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Shaykh Umar, repeated this ayah twice. Kalla, sawfa ta'alamun, thumma kalla, sawfa ta'alamun. The scholar says, as we mentioned before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't repeat the ayah just to repeat it. There are a reason to repeat it. According to our scholars, there are two opinions about that. Kalla, sawfa ta'alamun, the first one is for believers. ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, the second one is for disbelievers, for the kuffar. So the first one for mu'mineen, and the second one for kafirin. Another meaning, كلا سوف تعلمون, when you go to graves. ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, in the day of judgment. So we have two opinions. One that كلا سوف تعلمون, for the first one for mu'mins, and ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, the second one for كفار. Another say that كلا سوف تعلمون, at the beginning when you go to graveyards or to your grave, and you will believe that there is a punishment in a grave, there is عذاب القبر. And all of us knows that the hadith, when you go, if your deeds will be good, a man with white clothes will come to you, and you will be happy, and you will be asking him who is this good person or whatever. This person will answer you that I am your good deeds. And if you have bad deeds, a person will come with black clothes, bad black face, very ugly face, and you will be very scared. And you said, who are you? He said, I'm your bad deeds. So we know this is what you will taste first time in dunya, in the qabr. And the second time, again, in yawm al-qiyamah, you will see that again. You will know that what you were running will not benefit you. Just what will benefit you is the good deeds.
I just wanted to clarify this. You either get the good deeds or the bad deeds. They don't appear at the same time.
I didn't understand.
Do you know the figure?
No.
That it's either good or bad. They don't come together. You see what I mean?
No.
So, Dinai said that either the good deeds will come as a figure,
نعم.
Or the bad deeds will come as a figure.
نعم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the conclusion. Bad deeds, everyone has, every one of us has bad deeds. So will not come a big man or a small man with black and big one with white. No. So there is a general thing. Subhanallah. Naam, it's a general. So you, if you are righteous, yeah, subhanallah, how righteous you are, that person will come. The nur, the light of that person will be. As we will mention now, yawm al-qiyamah. Inshallah. Barakallah fiqh. So, as I said, we have two meanings for kalla sawfa ta'lamun, thumma kalla sawfa ta'lamun. Kalla, and again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, kalla law ta'lamuna ilma al-yaqeen. Kalla, if you know the right knowledge, the complete knowledge of what will happen yawm al-qiyamah, what will happen yawm al-qiyamah, what you will do? What you will do? If you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us some scenes in Rihlat al-Isra'i wal-Mi'raj about some people, the zuna, the rulers, some women, riba, these things Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, but still we didn't put the image in our mind as it should be. But yawm al-qiyamah you will see in your eyes what will happen to them and what will happen to you if you are one of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is confirming that surely you will know that, you will see that by your eyes. So this is very important. لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ. And some qurra make mistakes. They recite the ayah كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم, which is wrong. This recitation means if you know the right or the complete knowledge, you will see the jahim, the nar, which is wrong. This is something. And opposite that, if you don't know, so you will not see the jahim. And again, that's not right. Again, if you recite it, كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم, that means if you know the yaqeen, the surely knowledge, you will see the jahim, which means if you don't know, you will not see. And this is not right. So we have to stop. كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين, there is hidden meaning, علم اليقين, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show يوم القيامة what will happen to you. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, wallahi, it seems that, wallahi, you will see the jahim. Even the mu'min will see the jahim. You know the jahim?
Yes.
Al-jahim, the fire, hellfire. And we mentioned before that there are different meaning of hellfire. We say, al-nar, al-hutama, what else? Jahannam. Many meanings. And al-jahim, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ, you will see by your eyes al-jahim. Even the mu'min will see al-jahim. Even the mu'min will see al-jahim.
Yes.
So the ayah, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا, every one of you will pass through the jahim. Where? On the sirat. And what's the sirat? A sirat is it's a bridge between Jannah and Nar. And some people say it's on fire, on at the top of the hill fire, which leads to Al-Jannah. What will happen there? Everyone will go there, yeah? No, not everyone. The kuffar will not go there. The kuffar directly will go to hellfire. They don't need to pass. They don't need to try to go to that as-sirat. And as-sirat is not is bridge, but it's not like big bridges. It's sharper than the sword, thinner than the hair. Imagine if you have a hair, the sirat is thinner than it. Imagine that you have to pass, and it's very dark. Under it, the hellfire. Imagine that you are in the night, even if you have big space and you cannot see anything, how you can walk? Imagine that you want to walk at the knife, at the sharp of the knife, the edge of the knife. Will you be able to walk? No, what, Sheikh? Will you be able to walk in this? I'm speaking about dunya. Will you be able to walk? No, surely you will not be able. And you will start to move. And imagine this is a sirat, will be sharper than the sword, thinner than the hair, very dark, surrounded at what? Hawks trying to catch you. And thorn, shawk, thorn. You know a shawk, a thorn, which is, will affect you. This is the sirat. Now, who will go there? Muslims and munafiqeen will go to try to pass that. Kuffar will not go because directly they will go to hellfire. وهم وما يعبدون. Whatever the kafir, whatever you worship will lead you to hellfire. If you worship الشمس, you follow the shams and you will go to hellfire. If you worship tree, you will go with a tree to hellfire. If you worship al-nujum, the stars, you will follow them and go to hellfire. But now, al-munafiq, because al-munafiq, what will happen? Al-munafiq in front of a people is a Muslim. You will come with the Muslims and will start the competition, yeah? Who will pass? So the Prophet ﷺ will be another side waiting for you. When you pass there, the Prophet ﷺ is waiting for you to open the doors of heaven so you will enter. The Prophet ﷺ say, تفضل. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this chance. Say Ameen. So again, يوم القيامة will happen. The mu'mins and munafiqeen will go. Now how you will pass, as brother mentioned, it will not be that easy. What will happen? As I said, thinner than the hair, sharper than the sword, very dark, with hawks, and under you the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put at your shoulder your bad deeds, your deeds, and you will walk. What will happen to you? If your deeds is good, it will be very light. You will run, khalas, directly, you will run quickly, like a wind. According to hadith, some of us will pass like a wind, quickly. And we are speaking about the wind now. It will be like a wind. Some of us will pass like a bird. Some of us will...
Naam.
Zahf. Some of us, not of us, of others, inshallah, not from us, will fall down in hellfire. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send them to hellfire to clear them and again will go back. That's for mu'mins, Muslims. What about munafiqeen? They will start to go. They want to pass. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, stop. There is a wall. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put a wall between them and this as-sirat. Because the mu'mins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, there will be darkness there, very, very dark. So your deeds will light your way. As I said, if you are walking in dark, you will have a torch or our mobiles, we'll make something just to see the way. So your iman will be your light yawm al-qiyamah. Some of you, their light will be like a mountain. Imagine, your light will be like a mountain. With that way, what will happen to you? You are mashallah fit, like brother Omar inshallah fit, inshallah, and not heavy things at your shoulder. The light is very clear. You have a light, nur, like a mountain. You will pass directly. Some of us or some Muslims, their light will be like a palm tree, size of palm tree. It will be less. Some of us will be less. And the minimum one, his finger, will be his light. the finger of the foot. It will be the, that light. Sometimes going on and sometimes going off. When it's on, you walk. When it's off, you stop. Yeah. This is subhanallah. Subhanallah. But the munafiqeen, they will stop. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put a mountain or a wall between the munafiqeen and the sirat. As al-surah, the ayah says about the munafiqeen, يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا انظُرُونَا نَقْتَبِسْ مِن نُورِكُمْ. As I said, it will be very dark. And the munafiqeen and munafiqat will say to the mu'min, give us some nur, some light, so we can see and pass. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, ارجعوا وراءكم. Go back. Go back. فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا. Seek for a light. You will not find. Is there any light? عليكم السلام ورحمة الله. تفضل شيخ. Is there any light? No. You don't deserve that because you were munafiq. So you don't, you will not find that. فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا. فَضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ. There is a wall built between mu'mins and munafiqeen. لَهُ باب. There is a door for it. بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. Merciful. بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. The mu'min side will be with merciful. وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. And their side will be the عذاب for munafiqeen. يُنَادُونَهُمْ. The munafiqeen will call mu'mins. أَلَمْ نَكُنْ مَعَكُمْ. We were with you. قالوا بلى. Yes, you were with us. ولكنكم فتنتم أنفسكم. You followed the fitna. وتربصتم. You started to fight Islam. وارتبتم. You were about doubt about Islam. وغرتكم الأماني. You start to think about dunya, what we have, whatever we will do. حتى جاء أمر الله. Till the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes. And which is death. Now you don't have any thing. You were munafiq. So how do you expect that you will go there? You were harming mu'mins and you asking them now for your help. Give us some of your nur. No, you will not take your nur. Because Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha one day remembered Yawm al-Qiyamah. And she cried. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked her, why are you crying? She said, I remembered Yawm al-Qiyamah. And I was thinking, will us remember our fathers and mothers Yawm al-Qiyamah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, but not in three places. Where? Al-Mizan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala balance your deeds. Nashr al-Suhuf, how umqra'u kitabiyya, when you show your deeds as well. And un-Sirat, when you go there. You will not remember anybody, just yourself. You will not think about yourself. For that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about that, يوم القيامة, what will happen? يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. يوم القيامة, you love your brother. As I said, in Arabic countries, we think that my brother is my supporter. He is my wall. He is my wealth. He is. He will support me. But يوم القيامة, يوم يفر المرء من أخيه. You will run away. Give me one hasana, please. One hasana. I helped you a lot in your dunya. Just give me one hasana. No, no way. I need this hasana. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه. Your mother who carried you for about 9 months, feeding you, looking after you, cleaning you, raising you up. If you were ill, she will be ill more than you. Whatever. Your father who was staying from morning till midnight just to bring food for you. That day you say, no, no, everything will go. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه. Run away, I will not give you any حسنة. Again, وصاحبته وبنيه. His wife. You love your wife. You adore your wife. Some people, they worship their wives. Yeah, this is the fact. And even they put their mothers in another places for the to satisfy their wives. At that time, they will not accept. You will run away from her. And she will run away from you. You will tell her, you remember what I've done for you? I've done so and so to satisfy you. So I didn't force you. Go away. She will not give you 1/4 of her hasana. Even if this 1/4 or 1/4 of this hasana will lead you to Jannah, she will not give you. And you will not give her. Even your sons. So I accept you are for your, for my father. But that's in dunya. Now my child, myself. Nafsi, nafsi. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will state that. State that in the Quran al-Kareem, that nobody will benefit you yawm al-qiyamah. What will benefit you? Just your good deeds. That will benefit you. Even not your good deeds. Rahmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is will benefit you. Now again, ثم ترون عن اليقين. All of us will see the Jahannam. As I said, you will be sure at that time. You will saw the Jahannam. If you are mu'min, you will go through the Sirat very fast. If you are less, slower, and till the last person enter Jannah, will say, look behind him, say, Alhamdulillah, Alladhi najani. Thanks God, thanks Allah to Allah who saved me from hellfire. But some mu'min, some Muslims will go down to clear their sins and again will go to Al-Jannah. But munafiqeen, they want to go, as I said, there will be a wall and they will not be able to go and they will start to call mu'mins, give us some light, some noor to go through, and they will not get that. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. يوم القيامة, you will be asked about النعيم. What's النعيم? The نعمة, the bliss, the merit, things what you have in this dunya, like your ear, your eye. Is it نعمة? النعيم. Whatever you have, your health, you will ask about her. Your wealth, whatever you have, you will be asked. Your car, your house, whatever. And in the hadith that narrated that Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu left his house and he was hungry. And in the way, he met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again, the Prophet left his house and he was hungry. Sayyidina Abu Bakr asked him, why you are leaving your house? He said, because of the same reason which led you to leave your house. While they were walking, Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab left his house. They asked him, where are you going? Why you left your house? He said, الَّذِي أَخْرَجُكُمَا, which let you leave your house, same thing let me leave my house, which is the hunger. And the Prophet ﷺ said, let us go to one of al-Ansar, one of the Sahaba. He knocked the door, said, السلام عليكم. You know, it's from Sunnah to knock the door 3 times only, not keep ringing or knocking. No, 3 times. He said, السلام عليكم. The wife of al-Sahabi heard the Prophet and she knew the Prophet. She didn't answer. Again, the Prophet said, Assalamu alaikum. She didn't answer. Third time, Assalamu alaikum. She didn't answer and she left. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left. Then she called the Prophet. She said, Ya Rasulullah, I heard you from the first time, but I wanted you to say Assalamu alaikum more than one time. So look how they were looking for the how to satisfy, how to take ni'mah. Because the Prophet ﷺ, when he says Assalamu alaikum, it will be salam, peace upon them. So they were seeking that. She waited 3 times that time, which is, as I said, 3 times. And then she answered the Prophet. He asked her about her husband. She said, he went to bring water from the well or whatever. Then the Prophet ﷺ waited with Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Umar. The Sahabi came with water. When he saw the Prophet, directly he cut some dates. He brought some dates and he brought a sheep to slaughter it to the Prophet ﷺ and Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab. So they, all of us, all of them were hungry. Sayyidina Muhammad, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar. And imagine, they have cold water, they have delicious dates, and they've eaten meat. The Prophet ﷺ, he said after that, لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. You will be asked about this, that you left your houses and you were hungry. And now, mashallah, water, dates, and meat. Everything you will be asked about it. Unfortunately, some people always looking up. They don't look down. They do compare themselves with the higher people. They don't complain themselves with less people. That means inkar. You deny the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have always to say alhamdulillah. When you look to your situation, say alhamdulillah. Others, what? Less than me. So don't compare yourself with who is more than you. Because you will be very tired. If you want to do that, always there is better than you. Always. But if you look who is less than you, you will say alhamdulillah. As we mentioned now, when we entered, I was telling you, Brother Shafiq, it's cold. The mosque is cold. He told me, remember the people of Syria. You will be warm. When you compare the weather here, it's cold in the mosque. But remember the people of Syria. So you, what will happen? You will feel warm. Because they dream about this weather now. If you eat one dish, remember, some people they think one dish on the table, oh, I start to insult his wife. Only this is what you cook today. Remember that some people, they cannot find this dish. If your salary is that amount of money, say alhamdulillah. Remember that some people, they don't have a job. If you don't have children, say alhamdulillah. Some others, they are not married even. If you have whatever, always say alhamdulillah. Compare yourself with others. Always compare yourself with less than you, not who are better or say higher, according to your understanding. Because sometimes you think that they are better than you, but in fact they are worse than you. Like the person who was mentioned in the Quran, who? Qarun. Qarun, he was a very rich person, and we mentioned him before. At the time of Sayyidina Musa, the people were wishing to be like Qarun, that he has that great wealth. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy him and destroy his wealth. So they said, alhamdulillah, that we weren't like him. Always say, alhamdulillah. So you think this is better, this person is better than you. Actually, he's not better. And especially that sometimes the money may be fitna. If you have a lot of money, you may spend it in haram. So it's better, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better than you. I will not give him more money, so I will protect him from fitna. And some people, they want children. I want more children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated that again. Inna min abnaikum aduun lakum. Your wives or your sons may be enemy. They will attack you, kill you, do whatever they do. They may affect you, harm you. So you always say alhamdulillah, and always say thank Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the hadith, when you say alhamdulillah, imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you many things, but he doesn't need anything from you. Just to say alhamdulillah, and not by your tongue, by your deeds. Any question, brothers and sisters? Sheikh Omar, تفضل.
When he was talking about comparing for the people, is it required that you say alhamdulillah with that in order to prevent it from becoming pride?
Yeah, say alhamdulillah, you will not be pride, you will be satisfied, and always if you say, oh, why I'm not like Omar? Omar is, mashallah, even these people will not say mashallah. Omar has 1 million pounds. I have 500,000. Why I'm not like him? No, don't say that. Because you have 500,000. Even if you have 100, say alhamdulillah. Because there is a comparison in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. According to the hadith, غَلَبَ dirhamun, by the meaning alfa dirham. One dirham beated 1,000. How? A person gave one dirham, his ajr better than a person who gave 1,000. How?
Because he had less money.
Because the person who has 1,000, he has million. Actually, he who paid 1,000, He has million in his account. So 1,000 will not affect. While the person who has, who gave £1, all his wealth is £2. So he paid 50% of his wealth. So who's better? Who gave 50% of his wealth, or who just gave 1,000 from million? So sometimes, as I said, that you don't have money is ni'mah. Think it in this way. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about my situation better than me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't give me this thing for a reason. For that, when you make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't accept my dua. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows in your dua something will harm you, so prevented that thing from you. Or may he may keep that for you yawm al-qiyamah. So always say alhamdulillah. That doesn't mean to stay at home saying alhamdulillah. No, you have to follow the reasons, make looking for a job, looking to as a normal person. But if you don't have it, say alhamdulillah. Always alhamdulillah. Any question, Sheikh?
Waiting.
Naam, tafaddal.
According to the ayah, when they ask them rather to look back and then to look at some of their
moves. I can't hear you, sorry.
According to the ayah, Mr. Munafiqeen, at Yom Al-Qiyamah, they will ask the Mu'mins in order to look back at them in order to get the light.
Naam, to give them some light.
So the Yom Al-Yakun Al-Munafiqeen or Al-Munafiqat, the Ladina Aman Al-Duruna Al-Aqtabis Bimun, this as a group.
Naam.
So means the Mu'mins, they go together as a group. From the
eye,
I don't know.
No. Every mu'min has a nur, yeah?
Yes.
So you are waiting there. All mu'mins, imagine that we are inshallah mu'mins. Everyone has a nur. And munafiqeen behind this wall. And they know that all of us start to go. That means they will see there is a nur. They know that there is a nur. Give us, they speak to all of us, give us some nur. But that doesn't mean that all of us will go in a group. The Prophet ﷺ, according to hadith, will pass with his, what? His ummah. The first people who will start to pass through the sirat, Sayyidina Muhammad with his people. But not as a group, because they will not distinguish in this way. Because the people who has, as I said, good deeds, very good deeds, not like the people who has good deeds. Maybe they will go together, but one will, you know, at the beginning they will go together, but one will go directly, very fast, another will go down, one will overtake him, and this way. No.
Does everyone pass Sirat?
As I said, everyone, but some of us, some of them, they may, you know, for example, if there is some people who are doing bad deeds, they will not pass the Sirat. They will go to hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them till he cleans them, and again they will pass. They will pass. Now after they be cleaned, khalas, you are completely cleaned. You are punished, cleaned, your sin khalas gone, you will go to Jannah. Naam. But all mu'mins at the end will go to Jannah. So, and this is very important. Don't think that khalas, I'm going to Jannah, at the end I'm going to Jannah. But you have to think that one day in Jahannam equals how many days of punishment.
I think the analogy we use that gold, isn't it? When you have to purify gold, you have to.
Yes, exactly. When you purify gold, you put it in fire, so that will. Yeah, that's right. Jazakallah khair for this example. Yeah, Jazakallah khair. Tafaddal, Sheikh.
What about the 70,000 people they go to Jannah without Hisab?
This is exceptional, about 70,000 people who are going to Jannah from without hisab, and this is exceptional. Yeah, this is exceptional. Straight away to Jannah, inshallah, without hisab. Ameen. May Allah make us from them. Naam. Yani like, yani subhanallah, yani, like shafa'at al-shaheed, shafa'at Sayyidina Muhammad, they are different shafa'ah, but they will go to Jannah, but you have to remember the ayah, when minkum illa wariduha. They will go, but they will not, I don't mean they will not jump from the sirat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take them quickly to Jannah. Now.
Yeah,
Any other question, Sheikh? خلاص اوكي جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا بعلمه ان شاء الله سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نستغفرك لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته